Hi, this is Jennifer with choicebackgrounds.com, and in this tutorial, we are going to do some basic zooming, rotating. We're going to add a background, and then we're going to change that background. This ought to give you enough knowledge just to begin with so that you can start creating some really fantastic shows. First, we're going to look here in our folders list, and up here is where you're going to navigate through and find the photos that you want to work with, and I've already found this one here. I'm simply going to click and drag it down to my slide and then let go. I'd like you to change your slide time here by clicking on that 3 and change it to 8 seconds. And this is the length of time that your photo is going to be seen. This here is the transition into the next slide, which we don't have one. We're not even going to worry about that. So I'm going to change that to 0. We're not going to worry about having another slide. We're just going to work on this one right here. Okay, now to start working with this photo in this slide, you need to double click to come into the slide options window. And I'd like you to be in the effects, motion effects tabs. Okay, and all we're going to do to begin with is I'd like to kind of make it grow on the screen over the course of the 8 seconds. And to do that, we need to change our zoom settings. This is our starting position. This is our ending position. And so for this first one, this is keyframe 1. We're not going to get into keyframes, but this is your keyframe 1, and these are the settings for the first time you see your photo. I'd like you to come down to your zooms, click where you see 100, and let's change it to 50. Okay, and that shrunk your photo down to 50%. Now, over the course of the time of the slide, I want it to grow from 50% to, let's say, 80%. So click in your zoom box over here on the right for your ending position and type in 80. Okay, now let's just see what we have so far. This little triangle here is your play button. You can preview it right here. I'm going to hit this triangle button and we'll see it zoom in. And that's it. You've already made your first zoom. Okay, now let's add just a little bit more to it. Let's rotate it a little bit. My daughter's head here is rotated a little bit this way, and I want her to wind up more straight up and down. So it's going to start right here, straight up and down. I'm not going to change anything for keyframe 1. Keyframe 2, I'm going to come down to my rotate settings, and I want to rotate it a little bit that way. You got the slider bar here, and if you want to, just click and drag it and play with it if you want to. Woohoo! Now, I don't want it to rotate too much or it's going to fly around. So actually, I'm just going to make that rotate, let's say, to 8. And if you've got a different number, you know, say you've got 4 or 5, that's fine. Whatever number you land on, just make sure it's less than 10. We don't want it to be rotating too much. Now let's hit play and see what we've got. That looks really nice. We have a nice slow zoom and rotate. Just some advice for those of you who are just starting out. Subtle is better. You don't want things flying around and zooming around too much, or you'll make your audience sick. Okay, so now that we have that, let's see what we can do with the background. At the moment, the background is just black, okay? And it kind of makes it look like our photo's flying in the middle of space. Let's add a nice background that Photodex has given you with the program. Come down here where you see layers, hit this plus button, and then come down to add from media source. And you have some backgrounds already. If you click that, you'll get another window. I'm gonna get this from a ProShow Producer built-in content. I'll hit open, and it'll take me to my Photodex ProShow content folders. I'm gonna double click on backgrounds. And I have a bunch of backgrounds that Photodex has given me. And I'll show you how, if you haven't downloaded all of the backgrounds, I'll show you how to do that right now. I'm just going to click on one of these, and it automatically loads into that slide. Now, you'll notice two things. It's on top of my photo, hiding my photo, and it doesn't fill the screen. Okay? First, let's take care of the fact that it's on top of my photo. You can see down here in the layers list, what we just added is layer number 1. My photo is layer number 2. That's why we can't see it. It's hidden by this layer number 1. All I want you to do is click and drag down so that your photo is now on top of the background. Okay? Now, the other problem that we have is that the background doesn't quite fill the screen. I happen to be working in 4x3 and this background is widescreen. That's why it doesn't fill the screen. Come over to your layers, layer settings tab, and with the celebration or with whatever background you picked with that background layer highlighted, come over to scaling, the drop-down menu, and change it from fit to frame to fill frame. And now it fills the whole screen. Okay. And with all of these tabs, you always can preview right where you are. So let's just hit this triangle button here and hit play. And you can now see that your photograph is still growing and still rotating, and we have that nice background behind it. Okay. Let's do just a couple more things. Let's add a nice drop shadow to our photo. Highlight your layer number one, which is your photograph, and come over to the layers editing tab and come down to this bottom box here where it says drop shadow. And we're just going to check where it says off, check this square right here, and now it's on. So now when we hit the triangle button and we hit play, now you can see it's got a nice little drop shadow there on the side. Great, that looks really nice. Okay, now one last thing we're going to do in this tutorial is we're going to change the background. Suppose you pick this and now you're not really sure that you like it, but you've already resized it and you don't want to go through all those steps again. Any tab that you're in where you can see your layers, highlight that background layer, right click, and choose select file. This is going to throw you right back to where you found it in the first place. So now you can just simply pick another one. This one happened to have been my daughter's graduation. So I'm going to pick one of these graduation pics. And I'm going to hit OK. And now I still have the same motion. My background still fills the screen. I've changed my background. I still have the nice zoom and rotate with the drop shadow. Okay. Now let me show you, if you don't have all of these backgrounds from Photodex, they're really easy to get. Come up to File, Download Extras, Download Extras. And so long as you're connected to the internet, it'll bring up another window with all of these free things that you can choose from Photodex. Now, I already have the backgrounds installed, but if you don't, it'll have this dark blue text. You can just click on backgrounds and then hit install selected, and you'll get all those free backgrounds that you saw when I was looking for my backgrounds. Knowing how to zoom and rotate, add a background, and change a background gives you a great start for creating really good shows. Thanks for watching.